Greetings. The problem of Al-Aqsa. First, the word Jerusalem does not appear anywhere in the Quran. Islam has no right to the holy city of David. 1 Samuel 17:54. David took the Philistine's head and brought it to Jerusalem. He put the Philistine's weapons in his own tent. Thus ended the first Palestinian intifada. 2 Samuel 15:29. So Zadok and Abiathar took the Ark of God back to Jerusalem and stayed there. 1 Kings 10:27. The king, Solomon, made silver as common in Jerusalem as stones, and cedar as plentiful as sycamore fig trees in the foothills. The documented and proven history of Jerusalem is as capital of Israel. Daniel 9:24. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city. Thy holy city means Jerusalem. The word Jerusalem appears 801 times in the Bible. The word Jerusalem does not appear one time in the Quran. 801 times in the Bible, not once in Mohammed's Quran. 801 times in the Bible. Ask a Mohammedan, how can Islam claim any relationship with Jerusalem? Since the word Jerusalem does not appear anywhere in the Quran, they must reference this. Surah 17:1. Glory be to him who caused his servant to set forth night from the Masjid al-Haram to the Masjid al-Aqsa, around which we blessed so that we cause him to see our signs. Truly he is the hearing, the seeing. That's it. That is Islam's invented claim to Jerusalem. Masjid al-Aqsa means the farthest mosque. And what is the problem of Al-Aqsa? Basically, there was no mosque in Jerusalem when Muhammad lived. Some caliph realized the gaping hole in the Quran's claims. Muhammad claimed in his Quran, Surah 17:1, to have magically flown to some distant place. Some distant, unnamed place. So why would the creator of Islam devise a scheme to steal Jerusalem? I believe because the creator of Islam does not grasp God's full plan. God has a purpose for Jerusalem. Zechariah 12:2. Behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling unto all the people round about, when they shall be in the siege, both against Judah and against Jerusalem. 1,100 years before Mohammedism, God purposed Jerusalem with a task. Zechariah 12:3, and in that day will I make Jerusalem a burdensome stone for all people. All that burden themselves with it shall be cut to pieces, though all the people of the earth be gathered together against it. 2,500 years ago, God foretold the central role Jerusalem would play in the end times. Satan had 1,100 years to create a scheme to try and steal Jerusalem from God's covenant. And Surah 17:1 is the very best that Satan could come up with. An imaginary magic donkey ride at night to a faraway mosque. In a city Muhammad never actually visited. If Muhammad had actually ever visited, he could have bought hummus on the Via Dolorosa, perhaps stayed in the Sultan's suite at the King David Hotel. He could have taken selfies on the rampart walk of the old city. But alas, Muhammad settled for a bad hashish trip instead. 1. There was no mosque in Jerusalem while Muhammad lived. 2. Muhammad never, ever went to Jerusalem except in a drug dream. 3. Mohammed could not even think clearly enough to just include the word Jerusalem once in his Quran. Anywhere. There is simply no logical basis for any claim by Islam to anything in Jerusalem. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this mosque! Sorry, wrong cultural atrocity. It is illogical to think Surah 17:1 speaks of the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. First, the verse does not say Jerusalem. Second, there were no Mohammedans in Jerusalem during Mohammed's lifetime. Hence, there was no mosque there during Mohammed's lifetime. The structure was a later addition to attempt to de-falsify Mohammed's baseless assertions and inventions. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.